Howdy, Red Faction. How's it going? So, yesterday we did our hunter stuff for the season. I think we'll do that each week in new story drops. We'll do another warlock first, and then we'll go play another hunter, just so you guys can see it. Update for the purple faction. Streams are going to be on Mondays and Wednesdays, starting this coming Monday. We got we're gonna do PvP, so we're gonna do some Iron Banner. And then we're going to do a good bit of we're going to attempt to do Crota's End with my Destiny clan. It'll be the first time I do Crota's End ever, so I gotta really watch a lot of videos. I think the best one I'm going to probably watch is Fallout for a lot of that stuff. I might see some other stuff too, just to kind of get like a grasp on it. But with that being said, this week in Destiny, I gotta hide that. So this week in Destiny, September 7th, 2023. Hello in German, Guardians, because I'm not gonna attempt to do that. I gotta say, what a world's first race. Fire teams across the world competed at the highest level, and in the end, it came down to a photo finish between the two of the best teams around. I couldn't believe what I saw and how close the raid was. I just want to say props to all you who encountered Crota's End in contest mode, because it was a huge challenge, and I know that from experience, too. Before we get to today's TWAB, let's have a look at what we discussed last week and what we're talking about this week. Last week, the Crota End, Iron Banner dates, Turtle Power, Cabbage Patch, things about Stasis, Prime Gaming. This week, the final call for the Guardians for Maui fundraiser, update from the PvP strike team, the final shape, exotic, new ritual sets, the world's first winner interview, player support, and then movie and art of the week winners. There's 4 days left to show support for the devastation in Maui, the wildfires, all that, and this is what you can get. So be sure to support this campaign and everything. But moving on to something, I guess I think a lot of people, since Joe Blackburn did that little video, his own little developer Vidoc, announcing the PvP strike team. So, this is what is going on. In case you missed it, Destiny 2's fearless game director, Joe Blackburn, recently announced some exciting PvP news in a video a few weeks back. During the video, Joe detailed the ongoing work of the Destiny 2 PvP strike team, which, in addition to some other improvements, will be creating a brand new map pack coming next year. This team's goal is to make PvP experience more fun for players who enjoy facing up against other Guardians in glorious combat. Our objective is to not increase player numbers by forcing players who don't enjoy these activities to feel obligated to play them. Instead, we want to create a fun experience that entices players who have shielded away from Shaxx's calling to dip their toe in. The team has a few changes coming up in the short term, and are also working on long-term plans for what other improvements can be made. We can make. For example, in today's update, we added a high chance for non-adept trials weapons to drop from any trials match wins. That's actually really good, because of course it's going to be non-adept, so of course we all want the adept trials weapons, but there are some weapons that sometimes you just feel like you should want, because I mean, when you're doing regular PvP, you're doing that, and then you go into trials, and it's like, well, here's an auto wind. We could have gave you a messenger, but here's an auto wind. Our PvP strike team wants your input, too. We collected a lot of feedback so far, and we wanted to give you all another opportunity to share your fresher ideas on how you would like to see PvP continue to improve. As a specific example of feedback that would be very helpful for us, what game modes or rule sets would you be interested in seeing in the competitive playlist? We got some setup collection posts on our Bungie forums, Reddit, and Twitter. We value your input as we start to put together additional changes going forward, in addition to what we already have planned. So right now, the new Relic game mode is live in the lab for testing. another new modifier for multiple modes. Checkmate is starting up on September 17th. These modes tests and Crucible Labs are going to help us evaluate the success of these modes and how they might fit into other playlists in the future. Speaking of other playlists, one other thing we're currently working on is a complete restructure of a current playlist to create clearer identities and purpose for each playlist. We are looking at everything from which modes and maps in each playlist and matchmaking tuning to lobby balancing and rotation details. In addition to the playlists themselves, the PvP Strike Team will be focused on many things that touch our Crucible experience, including sandbox balances, spawn issues, rewards, and additional quality of life features. As we start to solidify more of our plans, we will share more details along the way. Until then, please go share your feedback. Okay, the PvE Strike Team and the PvP Strike Team have a little get-together and fucking fix Gambit. That would be great. I'd really appreciate you guys doing that, actually. Because, honestly, the mode is suffering from a lot of the problems that PvP suffers from. Map rotations are not that good. Maps in general are just... You can get some of the same maps over and over again, which is not fun. And in Gambit, it's even worse because we have very few maps. Rewards aren't that good in Gambit. I mean, the best thing you can get is probably the trust in the LMG. The armor never drops with high stat values. And if it does, it's like... But I'd rather have a 67 stat... total stat roll and have a very good armor stat here instead of something that I don't want. New Ritual Armor Set. A couple weeks ago, we mentioned that we'll be adding a new Ritual Armor Set into Destiny 2 this season. Today's the day following that the following armor sets can be earned as new Ritual Rewards. Introducing Hinterland, Biosphere Explorer, and Orsi. These are the new Warlock sets. You can earn these sets through playing Gambit, Crucible, and Strikes. So go out there and earn those armor sets. Clips from the... And the world's first winner. I think we all know who was winning this one. Last weekend, thousands of Guardians entered the world's first race and tried to be the first to beat Crota's End and claim the Raid Belt. But there can only be one, and it was a photo finish. A lot of teams reached Crota, but the Son of Orcs wasn't going to give up easily. The first team who reached Crota was Clan Elysium. It all looked like an easy win once more, but Crota had other ideas. Elysium tried and tried, but Crota did not fall. Finally, after 5 hours and 51 minutes, Crota was defeated, earning Clan Elysium their fourth Ray Belt. Seriously, what an incredible achievement. Congrats. Okay, so here's the problem with Clan Elysium winning their fourth Raid Belt. And this seems to be, I think, the third Raid Belt in a row for them? Maybe fourth? No, it's not, because they lost at Rue of the Nightmares. That's right, because I think that other guy did it. But I say the problem, not for the fact that they won it, is because every time they win, you always see, well, nerf this, nerf that. Buff these little mini things, but nerf these really big things. Well, we lost in this because of this. And yeah, that feedback is important, but for the people who... aren't, you know, in this game, who aren't doing the high level content every single day, to have something that could help them complete this and not have to sit here and grind hours upon hours to get this one little thing when you do it all the time is annoying. It's the same with PvP. When people say, well, this should be nerfed because it affects the value of PvP, not everyone has that time. And yeah, in PvP, it's a little bit more there's a little bit more cheese. In PvE, when people do PvE, they want to get it done. They want to finish what they had started. So, congrats! you know, on winning it, but try to lower the whole, well, needs to be nerfed, Bubble needs to be nerfed, Thunderlord needs to be nerfed, Divinity needs a nerf, this needs a nerf, this needs a nerf. I would love to see one of these people do an LFG, not, and then under a different profile, and try to do some of the stuff that they asked for in LFG. The know what to do, have 100 clears, have Divinity, and have the new exotic. That's literally what people ask for. You know, when you do LFGs for anything. Here's another interview. If you want to read it, you know, go ahead. Player support. All that. Due to an issue, can no longer be pulled. Some weapons don't have firing audio. Is currently not counting orbs generated in Gambit. That doesn't activate with Strand. Blah, 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 blah. Some art of the week. Here's some movies of the week. More art of the week. And, Well, with that being said, that's a wrap-up on This Week in Destiny. Or, This Week at Bungie, because until they announce the updates for Marathon, this will forever be the TWAB. Until that happens. But, Red Faction, with that being said, I am going to give this up. I'm going to relax a little bit before I have to go to work today. I will see you guys on Monday for some PvP and some Crota's End. That being said, see ya.